The following is a presentation of TFNN.
Let's go to Ed in Indiana. Ed, thanks for holding. Thanks for calling in. How are you today?
I'm doing great, Steve. You have such a gift on giving us stories to help us keep our mind right when we're trading.
We got Ed Young on the line. Now we're talking. Now we got a co-host for sure.
You know, Steve, I just wanted to call in a little bit of support to you because I always believed that an investor had to be whole-minded, and if they couldn't control their emotions, they could read the charts all they want and still hurt themselves. And you seem to be so balanced. You have such a good calming influence, and all the, you know, the little antidotes, you're constantly putting that in there with the technical analysis, and that is so, so important. And my hat's off to you. I'm still a listener, and I love what you do. And, you know, I just wanted to call and give my support to you, Steve, and tell you how much I appreciate it and how much it helps me.
I can change the world. I'll be somebody in your universe. You would think my love was really something. Maybe if I could.
Let's go over to Don in Odessa, Florida. Don, thanks for calling. Thanks for holding.
Hey, Steve. Thank you.
You bet. How you doing today?
I'm doing okay. I'm a subscriber to your service, and I just want to let you know that I sure do appreciate what you've done for me over the last couple months here.
Thank you very, very much. Let's go to Mike and Brandon. Mike, thanks for calling. Thanks for holding.
Hey, I love your show. Your show's great. You know, good common sense about everything, and you're laid back, and you're clear when you talk, and that means a lot to, you know, a beginning investor.
Susan in Boca. Susan, thanks for holding. Thanks for calling.
Yo, Steve, thanks for being there. And I just have one thing to say, just an update from the last time I called you.
Yes.
I was a subscriber.
Yes.
Just to your trial.
Yes.
Subscription. And now I'm a bona fide member.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
It is now time for The Trader's Edge. Now, Steve Rhodes.
Good day, money masters and treasure hunters. Welcome to the 4th of July edition of the Tom O'Brien Show. I'm your guest host, Steve Rhodes, filling in for Tom. And from all of us here at TFNN, we want to wish you and your family a happy and healthy 4th of July celebration. If you're not familiar with me, I'm the morning anchor here at TFNN. I kick things off each day, 9 a.m. for the first 2 hours of the trading day. It's a real honor and privilege to be able to call the markets for you, and that's exactly what we're going to do today. I'll also teach you how to use a set of tools, a set of leading indicators that will provide you with the independence that you're looking for to technically trade these markets. A set of tools that works on all time frames, all instruments, including the lightning bolt pattern, which really are the A to B equals CD patterns that we talk about, the Fibonacci retracement and expansions. Those are the Gartley buy, sell patterns, butterfly patterns out there. And then, of course, it's always about reading the message of the markets via candlestick charting and much, much more. I'm also author of a comprehensive daily newsletter service called Mastering Probability, out each morning by about 8 a.m. And for the first time ever here at TFNN, we are offering this service to you for a 2-week free trial, whether you've used the service or not in the past. That means 2 weeks, no charge to your credit card, for an incredible education and a system for being able to make some money out there. It includes over 30 hours of educational videos. And if you're looking for tools or a better understanding of the markets, this is the time right here, right now, to take advantage of this limited time offer. In fact, so limited, it'll be expiring at the end of this 4th of July weekend celebration. So don't waste any more time. I'm also author of a special report available to you at TFNN.com over on the front page on the left-hand side. The trend is your friend until it changes. Folks, I absolutely treasure your presence here today. My outcome, as always, is to help you to become a better money master and to provide you with the tools that each of us need in order to lead an inspired life. Because leading an inspired life, folks, that is what it's all about. So let's go look at one of our tools. This is the tool I call declaring our independence. You know, the 4th of July celebration, it's rooted in deep history. It's recorded that shortly after the Declaration of Independence was signed in Philadelphia, celebrations took place throughout the land, and many of the former colonists were just starting to call themselves Americans. Yes, we celebrate with fireworks, picnics, fun, and festivities, but imagine what it must have been like in Independence Hall when 56 men came forward to sign that parchment, the Declaration of Independence. Like it was noted at the time that they pledged their lives, their fortunes, and their sacred honors. And that was more than just really rhetoric. Each of those men knew the penalty for high treason to the crown. "We must all hang together," Benjamin Franklin said, "or assuredly we will all hang separately." And John Hancock, it is said he wrote his signature in large script so King George could see it without his spectacles. They were all brave men. They stayed brave through all the bloodshed of the coming years as well. Their courage created a nation built on a universal claim to human dignity, on the proposition that every man, woman, and child had the right to a future of freedom. For just a moment, let us listen to the words again. "We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. It is my hope that someday every people and every nation of the world will know the blessings of this liberty." Folks, all throughout our history, our presidents and leaders have spoken of national unity and warned us that the real obstacle to moving forward, the real boundaries of freedom, well, they come from within. It's absolutely true. And it has been ever since the signing of that declaration. Why, two of our greatest founding fathers, John Adams and Thomas Jefferson, who worked so closely together in Philadelphia for independence, they parted ways not too long after signing that declaration. You see, once a government was formed, something called partisan politics began to get in the way. And after a bitter and divisive campaign, even back then, Jefferson defeated Adams for the presidency in 1800. The night before Jefferson's inauguration, Adams slipped away to Boston. He was disappointed. He was brokenhearted. He was bitter. Politics is absolutely divisive. But here is what I know. The things that unite us, you and I, America's past of which we're so proud, our hopes, our aspirations for the future, for this much-loved country, these things far outweigh what little divides us. This weekend, we must remember that we are one nation under God, one nation indivisible. That regardless of politics, folks, we are all Americans. We must, I mean we must, pledge ourselves to each other and to the cause of human freedom, the cause that has given light to this land and hope to all around the world. From all of us here at TFNN, we wish you and your family a happy 4th of July. I say, let the fireworks begin, and let's go check out the markets here. Right now, we've got the Dow futures. They are trading off a bit here. Give me a moment to pull that up. They're off about 45 points right now. Trading out at 14,816 off of their lows here from early this morning. It's been a sea of red across the world out here. The S&P down 5, trading out at 1602. NASDAQ futures off 550, trading at 29.17. Russell 2000 off 4 points at 982. We've got gold up $5 right now at 12.48. Silver up 28 pennies, up 1.5% at 19.59. Light sweet crude backed off its highs from earlier on, but still up $1.85. Trading out at 101.45. Natural gas back a nickel. Our call number, you know it, 877-927-6648. Right now, over in Europe, you've got the DAX is off 108 points. The FTSE down 88 over in Asia last night. You had the Nikkei off 43 points. Not too bad there. The Hang Seng off 511, off 2.5%. And the Shanghai down 12. Let's start off by taking a look at light sweet crude out here. We don't normally do that, but let's go ahead and take a look at it. Here's the current contract. This is the August contract. And, you know, one of the things that we pointed out here was the rising price channel in here. We can see that price actually got right up to the top of that level, got up to 102.18 here this morning. What I'm going to do is actually flip over to the continuous contract. Thank you very much. And we're going to switch over to the continuous contract. In fact, let me do this right here. Let me do this and expand this up just for a moment there. Well, that doesn't show the exact same thing. But what we can see here, what I want to really show you on the continuous contract is Lightspeed Crude has absolutely broken the one-year consolidation level. It did that, yesterday afternoon. It really did it with conviction here today. And that says we could be looking at about $114-ish type oil out here. Next swing point up is at the 110.55 level, and that's going back to March 1st of 2012. So that most certainly is in its sights right now. And that's light sweet crude. Let's go back and take a look at what we've got going on here in the futures market. Now, what I don't know is if we're on Tom's clock. Al, maybe you could send me a quick signal here because I don't hear anything else in the other ear. Guess we're going to be on Steve-O's clock. That means we've got some time. Says we should be. Then we should be off here right now, Al. In any event here, I'm going to assume. My apologies, folks. Just trying a little technical coordination here going on. So let's go take a look here at the, let's go over to the futures. And as we take a look at the 30-minute futures here right now, we can see is the ES Mini has been traveling inside a sideways consolidation. And this sideways consolidation really setting up here going back to the time frame of about 9 o'clock in the morning on June the 26th out there. I need to just switch over to one thing here while we're on here so I can manage my time properly. That sideways consolidation, now we know one thing here about consolidation patterns is that they typically resolve themselves in the direction that they came from. If that's the case here, we're going to see a little bit of a move up in the ES Mini. Not necessarily today. We do know it's running into some significant resistance. Every time it gets up in towards that 1620 level yesterday, the high was 1618.50, so it's right around there where we know that the bears are just absolutely camping out. So we'll see whether or not, you know, we're seeing a rejection here of the lows of that consolidation this morning. Even as the market was moving down, you might have been wondering, you know, you got up, you saw futures were off about 100 points or so, nothing new there. But if you just simply went and took a look at the lows here, that came in at June 24th, the lows out there in the futures contract, 1553.25. From those lows all the way up to the high that was put in at 1620.50, that would take you back to the 1230 time frame on July 1st. If you go from that low to the high, the 0.382 retracement, 1594, you would have taken a look at it and said, you know, not a whole lot of damage, even with the futures trading down this morning out here. They're going to really have to break that 1594 area. Not that they can't do it, because we are into a sea of red out here. But even if they just simply make an A to B equals CD down, you're still looking at them only getting back to the 1578 level, and that really is nothing more than just the a normal retracement of this Gartley sell pattern that we see that is out here that was formed and created back at around 3:30 in the morning on June 28th. When we come back from our first break, we're going to go out to Lou in Nashua. We're going to take a look at silver and gold. And then what I'm going to do for you for this 4th of July celebration, I'm going to give you my take on these markets here. We're going to take a look at the short term. That means we're going to really take a look at the daily charts. We're going to go take a look at the midterm. And that means mid and long term, we can do that just simply by taking a look at a couple of the weekly charts. Our call number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. We'll be happy to take a look at your stock as well. It is a 4th of July celebration special. We'll be right back.
Who says you can't take it with you? TFNN says you can. With your mobile device and TFNN's live radio streams, TFNN has put it all in the palm of your hands. No special apps to download. No subscription fees for live radio or Tiger TV streams. We say you can.
Now let's go over to the dollar, because the dollar is going to be the generator. It is the generator of basically higher dollar, lower market. And what the dollar has done, and this whole uptrend, folks, has just gone sideways. The way it works, folks, is this.
We say you can. The Tiger Financial News Network. Smart investors and professional traders know you can. TFNN.com. Educating investors. With the launch of Tiger TV, TFNN has brought our programming to the next level. With Tiger TV, you can gain access to each host's charts and computer screens as they host their daily stock program. Whether it's Tom O'Brien, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, David White, Larry Pesavento, Andy Hecht, Victor Jones, or Daryl Martin, you can catch all of our technicians hosting their programs live and archived on Tiger TV for your viewing pleasure 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you haven't checked out Tiger TV, then visit TFNN.com and see what you're missing.
McEwen Mining is a high-growth, mid-tier producer in the Americas with a market capitalization of $1 billion. Experienced mining executive Rob McEwen, as chairman, CEO, and president, owns 25% of the outstanding shares of McEwen Mining and has put in place an ambitious business plan with the goal of qualifying for inclusion in the S&P 500 by 2015. With $70 million in cash and liquid assets as of the end of 2012 and completely debt-free, McEwen Mining is poised for growth. Production in 2013 is forecasted to grow at 24%, reaching 130,000 gold equivalent ounces. And over the next 3 years, McEwen Mining projects that their production will increase to 290,000 gold equivalent ounces, almost a threefold increase from last year's totals. If you'd like to find out more about McEwen Mining, click on their banner on the front page of TFNN.com or check them out on the NYSE or TSX under the symbol MUX.
Patterns, profits, and peace of mind.
Are you looking for a precision edge in the market? Something that can stack the odds in your favor? Then look into Larry Pesavento's trading newsletter.
Patterns, profits, and peace of mind.
In each weekly issue, Larry explains what's going to happen in the markets based on the pattern he sees developing and gives you actionable trade ideas based on those patterns. Plus, you'll get his detailed analysis on a variety of markets and sectors, including stocks, treasury bonds, the gold market, oil, the dollar, the Forex market, and more. You'll get access to all the patterns Larry is seeing in the markets, plus the Astro Harmonics and powerful Bradley stock market model that Larry utilizes for less than $5 a day. An extremely potent combination that will give you the edge you've been looking for. Try Patterns, Profits, and Peace of Mind absolutely free for 2 full weeks. That's an $85 value. Yours free when you register right now.
Get Larry's Patterns, Profits, and Peace of Mind.
And get the edge you've been looking for.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Steve, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go out to Lou in Nashua. Lou, thanks for calling. Thanks for holding. How are you this morning?
Okay. How are you?
I'm doing fine. Thanks for asking. You wanted to take a look at gold and silver? Tell me what you're doing, how I can help you.
Nothing yet. Just thinking of going long.
Well, I'd say now is a good time. Right now we've got gold is trading up $4.40. You know, if we take a look at the actual gold contract, it completed a 1 to 1.618, A to B equals CD down. It did it perfectly. The A point that you would be using are your May 3rd high, 1487.20. Your B point is the low from May 20th. Your C point out here was the high from June 6th. The actual price projection, 1178. We'll forget about the pennies. The actual low that we saw was 1179 on June 29th. That was last Friday out there. Created a little bullish engulfing candle. So if you wanted to go long, now is the time to do it. What vehicle would you be looking at to go long? Would you be using the GLD or?
No, the futures.
The futures. Okay, you're going to use the gold futures here. You know, I would say that in that case here, you know, you got to be careful on your stop. Your real stop on this trade here should be underneath the low from Friday. So you're 1248, and that level would be 1179. So that might be a little bit too much there to give for a wide berth. But I do think that gold has put in a bottom here. You know, so I'd say, you know, I really think the same thing in the case of silver. I think this is an opportunity for you to take a stab at it. You know, in the futures market, you got more liquidity inside gold than you do silver. But I think that both have put in a tradable bottom. Whether or not it's going to hold or not, you know, only time will tell. But it's really the first bullish signal. Quite frankly, it is the first bullish signal inside gold, in my opinion, that we have seen since April 5th of 2013 out here. So it is I think it's a good trade. You know, you might want to just simply take a look at the GLD, the SLV, the IAU, you know, one of the other ETFs out there. I think that'll give you a little bit more of a range there to be able to keep your stop in place out there. So that would be my recommendation.
Great. Have a nice floor.
If you're gonna trade the futures contract, then trade it off of intraday patterns, off of a 30-minute chart or something like that. But you know, that would be my recommendation. I would also say, with all the turmoil going on here, if you're looking to trade the futures contract, then, you know, wait until after the holiday and then step back in and trade those patterns. You know, you're not going to find a lot of bulls out there. I've started to hear some people talk about it, so you know, I think we'll have some pretty large snapback or rallies for sure, just simply because of the non-reportable group, the individual traders that have such high net short positions. So we should see some pretty quick snapback rallies once it starts moving. But I think you'll have a lot of time to be able to trade this.
Super. Thank you, Steve.
All righty. You bet, and have a happy 4th of July to you. If we take a look, folks, at things here moving in the pre-market, let me see here. We had Apple was up yesterday. They closed out at 418.49. You know what? I have to reset my system to see what it's actually trading at, since it was running all night long here. So my apology for that. But let's go over and let's take a look at what's going on around the world here. As long as we're taking a look at the markets, we're taking a look at the DAX here, trading out at 77.91 right now. It is down. It's down pretty hard. I don't have the volume behind it, but it's off a total of 118 points. It's off 1.5%, and it gapped down this morning. So not a good sign. What has held the DAX in place here most recently has been that 200-day exponential moving average. That's a little green line going across the bottom of my chart. It has not touched it today. There is 70, or the 200 EMA is 77.05. It's trading at 77.90 right now. No bullish candle at all. That's not a hammer candle that we're looking at there. So the DAX could be taking, if it does take out the low from June 24th, now you're talking about a huge A to B equals CD down. If we take a look at the DAX, you're looking at the high being May 22nd, just as we are in our market, and we're taking a look at the low June 24th, and your C point being the bounce up to June 28th. That'll send the DAX all the way to 68.88, and that'll take it all the way back to November 16th low out there at 69.50. If we go take a look at the FTSE, which has been struggling more so than the DAX. Give me a moment to go ahead and pull that up out here. The FTSE giving a bearish reversal signal here today, a evening star pattern. Boy, the FTSE already 10% off of its highs. That means we're looking at probably about almost a 20% move from the highs out here for an A to B equals CD down. 877-927-6648. We'll be right back, folks.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. With the stock market flirting with all-time highs and volatility back, now is the perfect time for a two-week free trial to Market Insights. On Monday, June 24th, Tom O'Brien closed out all five open positions in his daily newsletter, Market Insights, with all trades being profitable and ranging from a 2.23% gain all the way to more than an 11% gain in just one position for an incredible 32.7% profit combined between the five trades. Let Tom O'Brien's years of market experience work for you. If you'd like to see for yourself what kind of trading newsletter Tom O'Brien delivers to his clients each morning, then now is a perfect time to sign up for a two-week free trial to his daily newsletter, Market Insights. In a volatile market like we currently have, the potential for fast market moves like we've seen recently is a trader's dream. So don't wait any longer. Sign up for your two-week free trial to Market Insights today at the front page of TFNN.com. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts has officially launched at TFNN. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind software, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, butterflies, ABCs, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the market for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, and even months searching to find. As part of our introductory pricing, we're offering licenses available at only $59 per month. We're so confident that you'll love this new outstanding piece of charting software that we'll even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Lock in your low price today by ordering your copy at TFNN.com. Daryl Martin coined the phrase diagnostic trading, and we're happy to announce that his diagnostic box spread analyzer has finally been released. The diagnostic box spread analyzer helps you easily identify the best box spreads on Nadex in seconds, plus you receive access to the diagnostic deviation levels, as well as step-by-step training videos teaching you how to trade Nadex spreads so you can quickly master the mechanics of this simple yet powerful trading instrument. By pulling live data from the Nadex exchange, the Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer does all the math for you, calculating risk, reward potential, distance to break even for both outright spreads and spreads used to hedge the underlying market. Visit the front page of TFNN.com today to get your two-week free trial to Daryl Martin's Diagnostic Box Spread Analyzer and gain access to the valuable information it can provide when trading the Nadex box spreads.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
We're off to the races. We got the Dow off 55 points, trading out at 14,877. S&P down 8, trading at 16,05. Composite down 13 at 34.20. Russell 2000 off 4 points at 984. Google off $2. Apple up $2.50 out there. Microsoft back 26 ticks. Intel off 9. Cisco up 12. Leading the charge to the upside, Noodles and Oodles. Actually, it's called Noodles & Company. One of the new IPOs from a couple of days ago, NDLS, is the ticker symbol. So they're up a nice $3 out there. That has been moving ever since it IPO'd. wait for a pullback on that equity out there. Apple is up a couple of bucks. We've got Tesla Motors up $1.39. Arm Holdings, ARMH, up 86 cents. So not a lot to the upside here. Mead Johnson. Nutrition, that is down about $3.50 right now. That's off 4%. Anheuser-Busch, this bud is for you. That's off 3.5%, down $3. Wonder what's behind the move there in Bud, if there's anything. Nothing that I see here. Cummins Inc., CMI, off $2. Robert Half International, down $2 as well. That's off 6% this morning. BHP Billiton, down $2 and change. The FAS is off $2. Again, our call number is 877-927-6648. One of the things we're going to want to watch today is the Russell 2000, the futures contract out here. Reason being, the Russell 2000 has been the strength of the four ETF or the four indexes that we follow inside the market. You know, it's trading inside the May 22nd level. It's made the 0.786 retracement from the high to the low. Inside the futures, it didn't totally get up there. Inside the index, it did. Inside the IW, I mean, it really is close enough. 993.30 was the number. It's been up as high as 991.70. So close enough to have made the 0.786 retracement. Yesterday was a doji candle inside that futures contract. And so that means today's candle, any lower close, not only would it be leaves falling off of the tree, but it would be a bearish engulfing candle. And that's the only bearish candle that we would have seen coming off of last Monday's June 24th low out there. Of course, that's running into the resistance out here, this other bearish engulfing candle that formed here on June 19th. So it is something for us to be paying attention to. This is all about being able to read the message of the markets, where the bulls and the bears are hanging out and hiding. Now, I mentioned to you before the break, I wanted to go ahead and we're going to do that during the next hour. We won't do that during this hour, since it's now that we've got everything configured here, it'll be the 10 o'clock hour that we'll replay this evening from 4 to 6 as part of our July 4th celebration. So instead of doing that, let's go take a look at the currency pairs. Let's go take a look at the we'll take a look at the dailies first, and we'll go down into the intraday charts here. Now we got the Euro US dollar out here, moved lower last night, cracked through the 130 level. And right now, trying to form a little bit of a hammer candle. If in fact we were to see the close right here, which is right at the 1.29684, that'd be your hammer candle. So it would be setting up some support. It could also close at about 1.29826. That would be an even better hammer candle that could form. That's in the euro. Still a lot of trading left in the session out here, but it is trying to hammer out a bottom, having broken that 0.618 level. If it can't hammer out a bottom, then 1.28, let me pull this back here, about 1.2887 would be its next stop. That would be your 0.786 retracement out there. Let's go take a look at the Great British Pound. Let's go see what it is doing. And we're going to take a look at our friend, the Euro-Japanese Yen currency pair, to see what that is doing. If we take a look at the pound here truly trying to establish a bottom. We're now taking a look at the only bullish candle formation so far since that Gartley sell pattern that took place here and completed on June 17th. The Great British Pound has made the normal 0.618 retracement. Got down a little bit below that. Not a big deal out there. That level was 1.518. Today we are seeing a bullish engulfing candle. If in fact today you get a close in the pound over 1.5214 and you are short, you might want to tighten up your stops inside this trade. Why? Because normal movements are to your 0.618 retracement level. In this case here, if the bulls are going to step in and try and support this, you're looking at a bounce all the way back to at least 1.537, and it could get back to the 1.55 level. That is in your Great British Pound. Now let's go take a look at the euro yen. If we take a look at that, the bears ever present here this morning. We'll see how this holds here during the rest of the day. We're going to take a look at the intraday chart as well. But the real setup here, and this is why I believe the markets will still go ahead and move higher. And the question is, would you have liked to have known that information? Because at 7:45 a.m., that was the information that was contained in Mastering Probability. So as the market was pulling down and it was back and you were wondering, should I jump on board now and short the market? and you've not tried Mastering Probability, it doesn't cost you anything other than just a few seconds. Take a little bit of massive action. Go over, download it. You got access to it for free for 2 weeks free. You're going to get a market call early in the morning by about 8 o'clock out there. In this case here, I do believe the Euro-Japanese yen will still go ahead and complete that larger pattern, move up to about the 131.95 level where it's got the next Gartley sell pattern out there, and that is what will go ahead and trigger the move down in the markets. That'll be one of the things for us to be paying attention to. Right now we've got the Dow off 16, S&Ps are off 5, so you got the S&P and the Russell 2000 leading things to the downside. If we go take a look at the shorter term chart here, for the euro, Japanese yen, we're going to see here as it was moving down, as it got into the oversold territory, formed a hammer at 8 o'clock. That hammer was confirmed with a move higher going into 8:30. Now we're taking a look at a bounce that is underway in the pullback here. Now this is complete. Take a look at the patterns out here that this is complete. Of course, I only show the last 1, 2, 3, 4 patterns out here, but it's done just a beautiful job. The 1.272 butterfly sell. That was the light blue pattern off to your left. The 0.786 Gartley sell pattern. That's when it went ahead and moved down. That's the yellow area. Then we had the 0.786 Gartley buy pattern. That completed. That's your next blue. And then that turned into a 1-to-1 A to B equals CD up. The actual price projection was 131.27. Actually got up to 131.10 out there. That is a completion. While it was doing that, it got into that extreme oversold or overbought territory, and now it's worked its way off. And by working its way off, it's done just about a 50% retracement. Hasn't done the full 0.618, but we do see that the bulls have stepped in here. They're defending their area, and that area right now being the price level of 128.63 in the marketplace. As long as that level gets defended here today, we'll see maybe a flat, maybe a move back up to the 1620 or 1618 level inside the S&P 500. But we are dealing with a shortened trading session. That means all trading will be done at 1 o'clock today in the U.S. Markets out here. And, of course, we will be off at tomorrow and then back at them on Friday. First thing in the morning. So I suspect that with the big jobs number coming in on Friday, that's why I'm looking for that possible spike up that we would want to go ahead and sell into. If we take a look at the New York Stock Exchange out here, let's pull that up real quick. We did have the summation index again tick up last night. The oscillator started to tick down. It is above the zero line. That means the bulls still have the ball out here. But the real key, let's switch over and take a look at the indexes. The real key being this guy right here, the top of this chart, that good old VIXI, as Basil likes to call it. The VIX index out here above the 50-day exponential moving average. There is not a rally that has occurred. There has been no up move of any kind that has had any significance. And I went back to the 2009 time frame. I will probably do that during the 10 o'clock show out there as well, just to show you again. You've got the VIX right now at 1690. The 50-day exponential moving average is at 1585 right now. So the VIX would have to get underneath that in order for the lows that came in last Monday, the June 24th low, in my opinion, to have any meaning whatsoever. Otherwise, all we are seeing is the C point of an A to B equals CD. In fact, as long as we're in the indexes here, let's go take a look at those, see what we've got going on inside the Russell. So here's the difference between, well, not really the difference. We had a doji yesterday inside the Russell. You can see at the open here a little bit of a gap down. I'm talking about the gap down from yesterday's close out there. So you need to be able to color that in to know that you've got really a reddish candle out here, and the mere fact that we could be seeing after getting that 0.786 level. That could be the highs. I was looking for the Russell, you know, to spike that 1008 level. That's not out of the question if we see a positive response to those job numbers on Friday out here. If we go take a look at the, as long as we're in the index section out here, go take a look at the S&P 500, see what it is doing. The S&P 500 has struggled here the last two trading sessions as it tried to get over the June 20th downdraft. That high is 1624.62. Actually, didn't even test it yesterday. We've only seen one test, set up that shooting star that was from July 1st out there at 1626.60. If we go take a look at the ETS, we're not going to see any kind of volume today as people are off to start their holiday. And thank you for all of you that have joined in to listen to the show this morning. We appreciate that. If we take a look at the ETFs, give me a minute here to click on the right tab. That'll make it a little bit easier for us. If we look at the Dow Diamonds, really just a sideways trading range. Trading out right now at 148.90. They really still do want to make a run here for that June 19th low out at 151.05. If we take a look at the Qs want to make a run for the low of June 19th, that low of 72.68. That'll close the gap and inside the SPY. I suppose that, well, not suppose, we're looking for this, I'm looking for this to spike the low of, 163.38 out there. Let's go take a look at some of these stocks here that are moving and grooving, and we've got Chipotle. That is now the leader in the clubhouse. CMG is the ticker symbol. So let's go take a look at, so you've got Chipotle and Noodles and Company, apparently similar management teams, or the ex-management team of Chipotle now over at Noodles and Company. So they're probably having some fun here today. Chipotle gapping up a little bit this morning. All it is trying to do is to fill its gap. Its gap, where this thing broke down and broke down hard, was on July 20th, 9.7 million shares. The trading session prior to that, at 1.3 million shares, the low there, 396.98. That's where this is headed to. Volume here yesterday, as an example, 444,000 shares. Even at the highs, 300,000 shares back on May 20th out there. So it's moving in to a breakdown area with light volume, and that is what will set up your next possible short position inside of Chipotle out there. You know, just like we teach you how to buy a breakout, you want to sell a breakdown, and you're always looking for to come back to the area where it either broke out from or broke down from. In the case of Chipotle, it's headed back to where it broke down. If we go take a look at, I want to take a look at LinkedIn, LNKD. Haven't looked at LinkedIn ever since it had really formed that island reversal. So let's go see if that is still out there. You know, that had been a very strong stock out here, but it gave us a very bearish pattern. LNKD, give me a moment here to pull that up. And it's still out there. We can see that LinkedIn running right into the resistance area of that downdraft. Now, the downdraft was with volume. Can't recall what was behind that. Does it really matter? No, it doesn't. You had 11.6 million shares to the downside on May 3rd. The top of that was 187.75. We've only seen one test of that area. Was with 3.8 million shares on May the 15th. Looks like it went, well, let's see, maybe we had a second test. Looks like May 21st, that high was 187.30, 187.30 going against now 187.75. So it wasn't a complete test, but it moved in there with 1.6 million versus 3.8 versus the downdraft of 11.6. Yesterday, a little doji candle out there, 1.5 to the upside. LinkedIn really struggling here at the level of 187.75. Now, it has not backed off much, and not really so much a shortable stock at this stage, because other than that first breakdown, what price has done, it's come back, and it's got some pretty strong support right here. Not tested, but still strong support, because it's got that high volume day from February 8th. That level's 151.89. So, you know, maybe the reward to risk is there, but really it's been trading in a consolidation area. And the bottom of that consolidation, I would say the conservative side, I would use 165. So you're dealing with, what, about a 20-point consolidation out there. You know, I don't know if that's worth the reward to risk, you know, in a stock that, other than this one trading session right here where we had the downdraft on May 3rd, you know, whether it's really worth risking that. But you do have an island reversal out here. And that was from the trading session of May the 2nd. Let's go take a look here. Let's see what else we got. Let's go take a look at, Mead Johnson, MJN. That doe's struggling yesterday as well. So let's go see. So you got 2 days in a row, I believe, out here. Yeah, you know, yesterday moving back with volume, today too as well. I don't know what's behind this. And it's coming back to an area where it had broken out. It broke out with volume on the trading session here of January 31st. But it's already below that level. That level being 68.15. You're at 67.40 right now. Oh, here's where it's coming back to. This high volume low from October 25th should be headed down to about the $61 level. Levels at 67 right now. We'll be right back, folks.
take a hands-on approach to managing your investments. And whether you're bullish or bearish on Chinese stocks, the ETFs from Direction Shares are there to help you magnify your perspective. Bull ETFs for a rising market and bear ETFs for a falling market. Direction Shares gives you the tools for both sides of the trade. Discover how we can help at directionshares.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction Shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction Shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction Shares at 800-851-0511. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investor in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors employing dynamic strategies. Investors in the funds should understand the consequences of seeking daily investment results, understand the risk of shorting, and intend to actively monitor and manage their investments. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
Recently, Basil Chapman has had some outstanding trades in his newsletter, The Opening Call. Each morning by 9 a.m., Basil uploads his newsletter to the TFNN servers so that his subscribers can access his expert trading advice. Basil gives his take on the direction of key indices and updates any active trades that his subscribers are currently in. Just recently, Basil's subscribers closed out a short position in Chipotle Mexican Grill, CMG, for more than an $86 profit per share, over a 20% gain in just one position. If you'd like to try out Basil Chapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, then visit the front page at TFNN.com and click Trading Newsletters. There you'll find Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, where you can request a free sample copy. Also, don't miss Basil's program, The Tiger Technician's Hour, Monday through Friday, 11 a.m. Eastern, on TFNN.
Tom O'Brien's weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, has helped subscribers for over 10 years navigate the high-risk world of exploring and producing gold companies. And now's a great time to sign up for a free month-long trial to see the kind of insight that Tom delivers for his subscribers on a weekly basis. Every Monday, Tom O'Brien issues a quick update on the metal market, giving you his take on the HUI, XAU, GLD, dollar, bonds, and much more. Tom follows Monday's update with a full gold report, which is delivered to subscribers Tuesday afternoon with detailed coverage of 24 separate gold or metal stocks, as well as another 10 to 15 stocks that he lets you know are on his potential watch list. Get your month-long free trial to the Gold Report today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Don't spend another year navigating the metal markets on your own. Act early in 2013 and make the most of your gold and metal market investments.
Catch the Money Masters as they teach you the art of mastering money when it comes to trading and investing. Next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow now down 4 points. S&P down the same amount here. And the composite off two. Russell 2000 off two. Google's up $1.60. Apple is back 30. Let's take a look at Simon Property Group. Their ticker symbol is SPG. It's off about 250 this morning, down about 1.6% out here. But really not a bad-looking stock chart at all. If we take a look at the weekly, that's what I've got up on my screen here. If you're watching us on Tiger TV, we're going thrown back to the low on the weekly chart, put in, of course, March 6, 2009. That low, $24.27. And all I'm doing here is just simply showing you the trend line. The trend line here, the next area that you would tag would be the low of August 12, 2011. That price is $99.60. We can see here what price has done. It's come down. It's tested that trend line. It's held the trend line. Broke through it just by a tad here last week, the week of June 28th out there, but still closed right on that trend line. All it's doing is testing it, so still looks pretty good. What happens if it breaks a trend line? Well, when you break a trend line, what will happen is price will go back up, try to test it, and try to get back in. And if it gets back in, then it was really a false break to the downside. We can take a look at something that's trying to do that here right now. That would be nothing more than natural gas out here. And this natural gas contract broke that rise. Now, this here, not so much that it broke the trend line, although it did that as well. What I've got drawn in here is really the channel line. And if we take a look at the channel line, it works the same way. We saw natural gas break through that on June 27th. Got a little bit lower over the next two trading sessions out here. Yesterday, tried to tag it and get back in. July 2nd got up to 366, rejected that area even this morning as well. Got up and tried to get in and could not do it. Now trading lower. Sets up here. That natural gas probably wants to move down to about the 340 level. That would be your 0.786 area where this should move into. So Simon Property Group, if it breaks that trend line, it too will do the same thing. That's why when we go take a look at the indexes out here and try to take a look at what might be going on inside the market, since we know what is typically going to happen when you break a trend line, that takes us to the S&P 500. The S&P 500 on the daily chart out here, we can come take a look at that trend line from November 16th. Your next touch point is going to be the low of December 31st out there. The S&P 500 broke through it with conviction, as we know, on June 20th out here and broke through that trend line. Now all it's trying to do is to get back up there. Keeps running into the bears that hang out right around June 20th, maybe. What the bulls are hoping for here, or maybe what the bears are really doing, is just simply setting up a big trap. A big trap comes perhaps on Friday after the jobs report. We see a big spike. We see the S&P 500 spike up into about the 1635 level. Maybe does that by about 10 a.m. or so. And then all of a sudden we see the bears rush in and begin to sell the market. We have had a market that has been a big volume to the downside, light volume to the upside. You know, as we took a look at the New York Stock Exchange, which is the wider breadth of the market out there. In fact, let's take a look at it today, see what it is doing. You got the New York Stock Exchange off. It's the leader in the clubhouse on the way down, and that's very key. It's off 47 points. It's off 0.5% here this morning. So what we are seeing is a wide swath, a wide breadth of stocks that are selling off, because you've got net declining issues right now of 1,410 out there. There's a specific number that I'm looking for. Boy, I've got it written down somewhere on a pad of paper. And I think the number that I'm looking for is 1233. 1233, folks. You get net declining issues of 1233. Guess what? And you're at 1441. Forget about the spike up on Friday. Sell! Sell, Mortimer, sell! Folks, have a great 4th of July. I look forward to seeing you next hour or first thing on Friday morning. Take care, folks.
Hi, folks. I'm Steve Rhodes with TFNN.com, and the trend is your friend until it changes. A free special report is now available on the homepage of TFNN.com, and if you have money in the markets, this free report is a must. If your strategy is buy and hold, this report is a must. If you're a day trader, a swing trader, a Forex or options trader, or just getting into the markets, this report is a must. And it's the second best gift you'll ever receive. Look, if you buy a stock and the general market is trending in the other direction, you've reduced your odds of buying at the right time by 70%. Instead, let me teach you how to get that 70% advantage plus. The plus is a free trial to my daily newsletter service, Mastering Probability. There's no upfront deposit, no charge to your credit card, and I compress decades of education into each daily newsletter. This is a limited time offer, so act now, and I'll teach you how to take the trend and turn it into your best friend. All the details are on the homepage of TFNN.com. Act now.